I first started roller skating when I was 6 years old. I went to the roller rink and just fell in love with it. I then had to get introduced to inline speed skating. I inline speed skated for about 10 years of my career. My dream was still to always go to the Olympics since I was that little girl. So then I had made the switch about 5 years ago to long track speed skating. I was named to the 2010 Olympic team, going to Vancouver. I was the winner of the overall in the 1,000 meters. And later on, I had found out I was being taken off from a ruling, and I was knocked down pretty hard. A lot of people didn't think I'd be able to get back up, but I did. I was at the rink the very next day, still training, still finishing out the season. I think it was the second week of March, was the last race of that 2010 season. It was here actually at the Olympic Oval. I was racing the 500 meter. A little bit over 50 meters, I was going into the corner and I had slipped and fell into the pads. But I was laying on the ice facing the direction where I had just came from on my whole front side with my feet up in the air behind me and my leg, or my ankle, I should say, literally hanging off my leg. And if they said if they probably would have took the blade or the boot off with the blade, there's no telling my foot what it went with that. But I knew I was going to be okay. I knew that I was going to be sorry. I knew that, like I said, I was gonna be okay somewhere else. Someone was dying, you know. I mean, everybody happens every day. Our life is taken, a new one is being brought, and that's kind of what I kept saying to myself on the ice, as well. I just kept reminding myself that that there's surgery and I was gonna be okay. So I think that's kind of what held me together. It's funny that when I was on the ice, I never cried. I was kept my cool. I was fine. And now you can tell I can't hold it together thinking back to that. But I was in the paramedics being taken to the hospital, and I remember saying to the guys, like, "Am I gonna be able to skate again?" And they're like, "Do you not see your foot? It's kind of hanging off your leg." And I'm like, "No, I know, but I'll be okay. I'll be able to skate again." I've been pushed to my limits that I never thought I'd be able to push to. It's taught me to never give up, and that's why I'm back on the ice, back fighting for my spot now for 2014. It's taught me to be a stronger person. Other athletes who I've met in Colorado Springs were like, "I don't know if I could even do what you do." So just hearing that has helped me a lot to keep going, keep pushing, to prove everybody that my foot, yeah, was kind of hanging off my leg, but here I am today. I'm a big believer that everything happens for a reason, and there was a reason why I had fallen, and I'm back on my feet again. And freedom will find me, the satellites will catch.